Our Mass this morning, we pray for the living intention of Herb and Julie Haley. The deceased intention will be for the repose of the soul of Cindy McCoy.
The Lord looks into the heart. Then Jesse called. before Samuel. But Samuel said to Jesse, "The Lord has not chosen any one of these." Then Samuel asked Jesse, "Are these all the sons you have?" Jesse replied, "There is still the youngest, who is tending the sheep." Samuel said to Jesse, "Send for him. We will not begin the sacrificial banquet until he arrives here." Jesse sent and had the young man brought to them. He was ruddy and youthful, handsome to behold, and making a splendid appearance. The Lord said, "There, anoint him, for this is he." Then Samuel, with the horn of oil in hand, anointed him in the midst of his brothers. And from that day on, the Spirit of the Lord rushed upon David, whom Samuel took his leave. He went to Ramah. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I have found David, my servant. I have found David, my servant. Once you spoke in a vision, and to your faithful ones you said, "On a champion I have placed the crown. Over the people I have set a youth. I have found David, my servant. I have found David, my servant. With my holy oil I have anointed him, that my hand may be always with him, and that my arm may make him strong. I have found David, my servant. He shall say of me, 'You are my Father, my God, the rock, my Savior.' And I will make him the firstborn, highest of the kings of the earth. I have found David, my servant."
Alleluia.
Forget that there were rules in paradise. Remember, God told the man, is the remembrance of Jesus. We have a great love for the Mass because we Catholics, we realize the Mass is the life we will live in paradise. We will watch Jesus Christ show God the Father his great love for us. We will feast forever in the presence of the bride. St. Mary the Assumption. Our Lady was there. Peace radiating from her countenance. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God
Pray, my brothers and sisters in Christ, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the
Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all of his holy church. Grant us, Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and true God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you come to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores you and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exalted praise as we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mercy on us all, we pray. us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," not on your sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Lamb
of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. You have prepared a table before me, and how precious is the chalice that quenches my thirst. Now we'll prepare spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you in my soul. Since all of you are both dear to me, cannot now receive you sacramentally, I ask that you come to me spiritually into their hearts. Though you are already in our hearts, help us to embrace you and unite ourselves wholly to you. Permit now that we should ever be separated from you. Let's pray. Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness, make those who have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Bow
your heads and pray for God's blessing. Bestow the grace of your kindness upon your supplicant people, O Lord, that formed by you, their creator, and restored by you, their sustainer, through your constant action, they may be saved, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Glorify the Lord by your life. St. Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him and humbly pray. Do thou, Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits, prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls.